All right, so let's do a very quick video about saving seeds from tomatoes. Tomatoes, of course, are actually fruits because they're mature ovaries of the plant, and they're brightly colored and they taste good because they're designed for animals to eat them. The seeds are actually kind of designed to go through the digestive system of a living organism. So if you look at these seeds, let me pull a few out. You may notice that the seed is surrounded by this little bit of gel. That's kind of in a little jacket. And it's designed because that's tasty. And so organisms like us, like chickens, will take that and they'll eat it. If you try to save these seeds and just plant them with that on it, it's got some inhibiting chemicals. It'll keep the seeds from germinating. So you really don't want to do that. So you need to get rid of it. So, of course, you could eat it and, you know, save the poo, but, of course, that's incredibly gross, and we're definitely not doing that. So, instead, what I do is I'll actually pull these out, rinse them in water, and then I put them in a container like this. So, notice you can kind of see that they still have those little coats on them. But what I do is I actually spit into this container, which may also be gross, but I think it's a lot less gross than having a cup that's completely covered in mold fuzz. And when you do this, it causes that outer coat to start to break down. Some of these seeds have actually been in there for a while, so it's kind of broken down a little bit on some of them. But some of them I just added. And what you'll notice, and you can see kind of the bubbles, some of that's from the spit. This is relatively low. There's not a lot of volume. So we want to get, why do I use spit? Because it has enzymes in it that start the digestion process. So the enzymes will help break down the outer coat, that outer kind of fruit jacket, not actual true fruit, but basically that little jacket of gel that's on those seeds, which we need to get rid of. And you'll end up with a really clean seed once you're finished with it. And you can use any tomato to do this. What I like to do is I just take my knife and just pop some of these out. But what you want to do is try to just get the seeds. Try to pull out just the seeds. Now this way is kind of tedious, which is why a lot of people do the fermentation method. But if you're a small gardener and you don't have that many tomatoes, and you don't want to make a big stink with fermenting semi-rotten tomatoes in your garage, this is another way to do it. What you can do, you can kind of dump the surface layer off. And then, kind of try to rinse the extra bits off, and most of the seeds will go to the bottom, so you can just keep dumping that out. I'm on my deck, so not really a big deal. If you get really annoyed by these, you can actually just pull them out. And then, once you've rinsed it a little bit, you've got mostly clean seeds. So then, I add the spit, let it sit for about 2 or 3 days, and then you go from there. It's even easier if you have a cherry tomato, because really they don't have much gel. So with the cherry tomato, all you have to do is you rip off the top, you take your cherry tomato like this, and you squeeze. And ta-da, you just have pure seed. So cherry tomatoes are like super, super easy. And then basically you can just rinse these a few times, and then you go right into your spit treatment. When you do the adding spit part, if you or your man, or you are a man, don't hawk a giant loogie and like get a bunch of gunk in there. You want some nice, clean, clear saliva, just some real clear stuff. Just a little bit of bubbles, and that will contain really pure enzyme to help break these down. All right, so it has been 48 hours since I put my tomato seeds in the spit solution. And you can kind of already tell it's gotten kind of cloudy. And if you look at the seeds, you can see that they don't actually have that jacket anymore. So I'm going to rinse these off and show you afterwards that they don't have that little fruit jacket. It's all been broken down. If we look carefully at the seeds now, see, there's no fruit jacket, but there might be what looks like a white fuzz on them. And that's actually just a little bit of hairs that are on the surface of the seed. And that's normal. That you're not going to remove. It doesn't have any of the germination inhibitors in them. So what you'll do at this point is you're going to want to let them dry out. So sometimes what I do is I'll put them on a paper towel, but sometimes they get stuck to the paper towel. You can put them on a plate, but sometimes they get stuck to the plate. Sometimes I just leave them in this bowl and let the water evaporate. All right, so I've had these guys sitting out in the sun for a couple of hours, and they've dried up. So that's what we need for seeds. Now, they're a little bit stuck, but basically if you pick at them gently, they come right off. You could use like a knife or something, like a butter knife, to pull all of these out. But basically, once you've got this, they're ready to go into storage. So as long as they're dry, they're fully dry to the touch, you can store them. And I like to use old medicine bottles or little jars. Those are pretty useful. And that's basically how you save your tomato seeds. So over here, I did these are cherry tomato seeds. So you can tell that they're a lot smaller, and you can see those little kind of whitish hairs that are on the surface of the seeds. And I just spread these out on a plate. Oh, and you gotta be careful with the wind. Before I pulled them off, they wouldn't have blown around in the wind at all. But now that I have, they're a little bit sensitive to wind. So I'll have to go and put them in storage, put them away. All right, so this is how I store my tomato seeds. This is a variety called Cernkovic Yugoslav. The only other little bit of weirdness you might run into is a lot of times the seeds will stick together, and you can just kind of rub them between your fingers to make them come apart. So what you should do now is keep this inside, keep it cool. A lot of times I will actually put mine in the refrigerator. That ensures that they're going to stay good for a really long time, so they'll stay viable. So if you're interested in this sort of thing, like and subscribe. I do lots of botany and, of course, just general gardening type of stuff. So the intersection of botany, gardening, living organisms. That's me.